He also called Jordan selfish.
As in Michael Jordan, selfish?
Yeah.
Well, how? Why wouldn't you be? Okay, so let me tell people this, because they call him, he's the Messiah, he's the greatest of all time, he's the GOAT, he's the king. All kings are selfish.
Right.
Right? That's what you do in order to build your kingdom. And I don't think he's selfish. He just is an alpha male playing in a team game and was really good at it.
Right. He was talking about Jordan leaving the Bulls to play baseball. His father just died, though.
Okay, but this is another thing. Saying he's selfish, that he went and took care of his own life. I said this to my cousin Mike, Fat Mike.
Let me just tell you the whole quote, just so you know, you have the full story. When he was talking about him leaving to play baseball, what Scottie said was, yeah, it was a big decision, but it was a selfish decision. But it was kind of who Michael Jordan was. That was a guy who believed he could do anything on his own. So he basically felt like Michael didn't give the credit to the rest of the team for winning all these championships. Felt that it was really all him. According to Scottie.
It was, because if they would have lost, it was on him.
That too.
So if you lose, you get it all. When you win, you should get it all. Okay? And the reason 80% of the reason they were even in that position is Michael. You got to give that. So, and he became so much more than anybody could have ever. I told you, James Worthy and I, you know, we couldn't believe that the skinny Michael has become the Messiah. Like, certain player, like, people, Michael was correct. People were saying Clyde Drexler was better than Michael Jordan. And when they were going after each other in the 94 trials for the NBA, when they used to have pros and college guys play, those were the games to watch, Michael going after Clyde and back and forth. So I just say that. I just say they have to pay attention to the fact that Michael, everything, all that was on his shoulders. They didn't say anything when anybody else walked into the American Airlines arena. They said it when Michael did. When they would stop other games and say, or in the midst of the game, hey, Michael Jordan just came into the American Airlines Center, be back at 3 o'clock, you know, stay tuned. That first game, people were like, I'm only watching that so I can get to watch Michael. Mm-hmm. So he and David Stern changed the image of the NBA in 1984. They used to say it was too black, too drug infested. All of a sudden.
They were saying that?
Yeah, they used to say
that. Too black and too drug infested. Drug infested in terms of what?
It was cocaine use.
Oh, really?
80s. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I mean, they went over that in the Last Dance.